What's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to Flourish with Delores. In today's video, I am gonna share a little bit about my influencer journey, and we're gonna get to the chase. I am gonna share who won our 3 giveaways from our Vlogmas videos. So if that sounds good, keep on watching. So I'm out of breath because we've been running around packing for our big trip. We are going to Ghana. So super excited to go back home where I was born. But we've been running around and I'm like, wait, I gotta stop and do this video before we leave, because I really want you all to know who won. And so we'll get started with that. So thank you all for supporting me throughout my social media journey. I mean, when I started in 2019, April actually, when I launched my podcast. And a little bit about my background, I work in higher education. So my bachelor's and master's is in social work and my doctorate is in higher ed. And I got my doctorate in higher ed because I've always wanted to be not all my life, but when I got to college and got to know some deans of students and some academic advisors, I realized that I wanted to work in higher ed and got my doctorate because I wanted to be a dean of students. So once I finished my doctorate, I was so excited. I thought my life was gonna be made. I'm done with school. I'm starting my job, a dream job. And adulting does not work that way. I quickly realized that it's really not easy. And I would look on social media and see everyone else looking pretty excited and happy in their careers. And I start to think like, dang, what's wrong with me? Like, I invested all of this and I'm still not feeling super complete. And so the more I would talk to my friends, my sorority sisters, family about how they've been doing in their careers, they had similar sentiments of struggling to adjust to working professionally, being done with school, that post-grad depression kicking in. And I'm like, gosh, like, you don't really see a lot of this on social media. A lot of people keeping it real with the struggles. Social media can tend to be a highlight reel. So once I started realizing that my story wasn't unique, I wanted to share these stories with everyone, so that other people would know that they weren't alone. So I started my podcast, and that's really how I got my foot into the whole social media world, because I just wanted to share stories of other young professionals to hopefully inspire other people to know that they're not alone in the struggle, and that progress over perfection is what we want to strive for, because it's humanly impossible to be perfect. So when I started my podcast, my Instagram page was completely private. I think I had like 1,000 followers, and I was also following 1,000 people, like pretty much like just my friends or people I've met along the way. And I didn't really even know what an influencer was, to be honest. I thought influencers were only like the sexy, like Instagram models, or like the girls from like Love and Hip Hop. Like, I didn't realize it was regular girls like me sharing what they love, inspiring other people, sharing their faith, their journey, sharing products that they love. And so it didn't really open my world to that until I started trying to promote my podcast and realized I couldn't keep my page on private and stay into my own little bubble, because I really wanted my podcast to grow. So once I made my page public and started following more people, making more friends, I started realizing, you know, the whole influencer world. And it wasn't until about a year later, December 2020, exactly a year from now, when Fabletics reached out to me. And by then I started my YouTube channel because I wanted to share more of me and my personal life and journey to hopefully inspire other people. And so I was just minding my business, you know, doing my YouTube thing, connecting with people on Instagram, not really from the influencer lens, but just from, you know, check out my podcast, check out my YouTube channel, you know, let me check out your stuff, let's collaborate. And in the back of my mind, the more I started seeing influencers as I was following people, I was like, I wonder what it'd be like to pitch brands. But I always thought I wasn't ready, or I had to have like a certain feel or aesthetic. And in December 2020, Fabletics contacted me, and I was shook, y'all. Like, first of all, I thought it was a scam. I had, I sent it to my brother, I sent it to my cousins, a couple friends, like, what do you think about this email? And then I looked up the contact on LinkedIn, made sure that she officially worked at Fabletics or influencing agency. And so that was really my first, you know, feel of working with a brand. And I've been working with Fabletics every single month since. I worked with a few brands like Dr. Dennis Gross's skincare products. I've worked with I'm gonna pop them up on the screen, but just so many brands that have, you know, it's just been so cool. And I think one of the biggest things that I've learned while influencing is that you have to really start to know your worth. And so that has been a good practice for me, because if a brand approaches me, and first of all, I only work with brands that I have either tried their product, or I'm going to try their product before sharing, or if I'm sharing, I'm letting you guys know that I'm trying it with y'all, let's see how it is, and I have a coupon code for you. So you really have to be authentic to sharing what you love, what you actually use, because it's important for my community to trust me. But the other thing, getting back to value, is when a brand asks you, well, what's your rate? Or most brands will try to push free products instead of paying you. So you have to really start knowing your worth of saying, nope, this is actually my rate. And I would lowball myself all the time because I would be afraid that they would say no if I gave them what in my mind I would like to get paid. So it's really taught me to know my value, ask for it, and if they can't, and I'm not interested in continuing the partnership, then I don't. So yeah, so that's been a really cool practice to implement what you're worth and be able to ask for it. So the other thing I really love about influencing is the community you get to create. Like, that's probably my number one, is getting to know you all. And so that's why when you guys comment on my stuff, I get so excited, because I then actually know who I'm talking to, and I know you're watching, and I know you appreciate it, and that I'm adding value to your lives, because that's ultimately why I even started all of this, is because I want to make impact and add value to other people's lives. So that is pretty much my influencer journey in a nutshell. I went really fast because, as I said, we're packing and have some places to go and things to do. But Vlogmas, y'all, I don't know if I'll do it again. I definitely wouldn't do a video every day. We had fun with it, but overall it's just stressful trying to make sure everything is in order, even if you record ahead of time, because I think I recorded about 10 videos pre-recorded, but you still have to have them edited, whether you're editing it yourself or having someone else edit. You have to wait for them to edit. Shout out to my editor, because when I started my social media journey, I was editing my own YouTube videos, my own podcasts, and working full time and trying to manage everything else in my life, I just had no time. And so shout out to Podbear, Rashid, for editing my videos. And so that's been a huge help. But anyway, so you have to wait for your editor, or you have to edit, then you need the thumbnail, the description, you gotta do research. Like, it's a lot to bang out 25 videos in a month. So I probably won't do it the way I did it this year if I were to do it again. But I will say one of the greatest things is, especially because I made it a little bit of a competition with our giveaway, one of the greatest things was getting more comments and being able to talk to you guys more. So I hope you guys continue to comment on my videos. Down the line, I would love to do more giveaways here and there, so definitely tune into that. And yeah, let's get actually into this giveaway, because that is why you are here. So the way it's gonna work is we put all of your names into a system that spins a wheel. So if you commented, the rule was to comment at least 3 times and subscribe to my channel. So if you did that, your name went into the wheel once. If you commented on like every one of my videos or a good majority of the Vlogmas videos, then your name went in, I think we did 5 times if you did all of my videos and 3 times if you did the majority of my videos, just to make it fair for those who've really been holding me down, authentically commenting on all my videos. I wanted to give you guys some bonus entries. So let's get right into it with spinning the wheel. All right, so we're gonna spin the first wheel. I can't talk. We're gonna spin the first one. The first person who wins is going to get the fashion footwear shoes. So let's see who that winner is. Gaynell, congratulations. You are getting fashion footwear shoes. Girl, I love them. And anybody watching this who wants fashion footwear shoes, you can get 35% off using Flourish with Delores code. Highly recommend. They're great shoes, and I love that you get the 2-in-1 shoes. So Gaynell, if you can email me, my email's in the description box, or you can DM me on Facebook. Let me know your shoe size and the best address that we can send it to you. And I'm gonna let you pick out the heel that you want. So I'm gonna message you back with the options that you have. Congrats, girl. All right, so then the next one is going to be from our Black-owned business called Booked. They sell beautiful journals, and what better way to start the year with reflecting with yourself? I'm big on this, so I really wanted to give this to someone. And so let's spin for that. I'm like, is it gonna keep going? Anaya, girl, you won the book journal. DM me your address where I can send it. And I'm gonna let you pick. I think there's two journals that are amazing that Booked has. So I'm gonna let you pick which one you want and then order that for you and have it sent to your home. So thank you so much for your support, girl. And congratulations. And the next winner is Nikki. Congratulations, Nikki. You are winning the $50 cash prize. So DM me your PayPal email if you have PayPal. If you don't have PayPal, send me your Venmo and I will send you the $50 gift card through that option. So thank you so much. You three have until December 31st to reach out to me to claim your prize. If not, it's going to go to the fourth winner, fifth winner, and so on and so forth. So thank you guys so much for supporting me. I'm gonna take a much needed break. I got my vacation here, y'all. I'm ready for Ghana. I'm gonna take a much needed break so you won't see a video for the next 2 weeks, but make sure you turn your post notifications on so you never miss a video. Just like I was consistent through Vlogmas, I'm consistent throughout the year. I post every single week. I'm going back and forth between Wednesdays and Sundays. I'm not sure which one I wanna do in the new year, but please make sure you turn your post notifications on so you never miss a video. And if you have any video suggestions that you wanna see me do in the new year, let me know and I will see you in the new year. Peace.